Hello everyone, my name is Pranav and today I am going to discuss about the topic measuring diameter of a circle within an image. This presentation is based on IEEE paper, a new method of circle center and radius detection in an image processing. So let's start. So this is the content that we are going to see in this presentation. These are some topics that we are going to deal with in the presentation. So why we need to detect the circle or its radius and center. So if we see, whenever an human eye is unable to detect a circle or its size, this topic can help us in detecting this. Measuring objects within an image or frame can be an important capability for any applications where computer vision is required instead of making physical measurements. So how do we detect a circle? In order to detect any circular object, we need to detect the edges of the object. Edges are the points in the image where there is sharp change in the color. So in order to get this sharp change in the color, we need to differentiate the color of the background and the color of the circular image in the picture. So in order to make it differentiable, we need to make the background darker or lighter. So once we make the background darker or lighter, we can easily distinguish the sharp change in color in the image. By that, we can easily detect circles. Here we are using Herc transform. Herc transform is a feature extraction technique used in image analysis, computer vision and digital image processing. The purpose of the technique is to find the imperfect instance of object within certain class of shapes. We will be taking the idea from this algorithm to find the centers and the radii of the detected circles. So let's see how we are finding the radius and the center of the circle theoretically. So let's consider a circle and three points on the circumference of the circle named P1, P2 and P3. So let's make two chords out of them that are P1, P2 and P1, P3. So let's consider the point P1 as Y1, X1, Y1, P2 as X2, Y2, P3 as X3, Y3. So now let's draw two perpendicular bisectors of these two chords, and the intersection of the two perpendicular bisectors of the chords will be the center. So let's give the points P4 as the perpendicular point of bisection of chord P1 P2 and P5 as a point of bisection of the chord P1 P3. So here point P4, we can find out point P4, that is X4 Y4, by the values of X1 and X2, and Y4 from the values of Y2 and Y1. Similarly, we can find the values of point P5, that are X5 and Y5. So as like chord P1 P2 is a line, it has its formula, that is Y equal to K1 X plus B1. So here K1 is the slope and B1 is the intercept. So we have the formula of the slope, that is K1 equal to Y2 minus Y1 upon X2 minus X1, and the formula for the intercept is B1 equal to Y1 minus K1 X1. So similarly, we will find the slope and the intercept of the line P1 P3. After that, we will find the equations of the lines that are perpendicular bisectors. Let's consider them as y11 equal to k11x plus b11 and y22 equal to k22x plus b22. So here, if we consider, we will get that k11 is the slope of the first perpendicular bisector and K22 is the slope of second perpendicular bisector. As K11 is the slope perpendicular to the K1, it will be equal to minus 1 upon K1. So वी गेट के वन वन इक्वल टू एक्स वन माइनस एक्स टू अपॉन वाई टू माइनस वाई वन एंड बी वन वन इक्वल टू वाई फोर माइनस के वन वन एक्स फोर. सो सिमिलरली वी विल गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ के टू टू एंड बी टू टू फ्रॉम द वैल्यूज ऑफ के टू. सो आफ्टर आफ्टर गेटिंग के टू टू बी टू टू एंड के वन वन बी वन वन वी कैन ईजिली फाइंड द कोऑर्डिनेट्स ऑफ द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल दैट आर एक्स जीरो एंड एक्स वाई जीरो. हियर वी जस्ट हैव टू पुट द वैल्यूज ऑफ बी एंड के. सो देयर वी कैन ईजिली गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एक्स जीरो एंड वाई जीरो. सो आफ्टर गेटिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स जीरो एंड वाई जीरो वी कैन फाइंड द रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल वेरी इजी. दैट्स रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल इक्वल टू अंडर रूट एक्स जीरो माइनस एनी पॉइंट ऑन द सर्कल ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर प्लस वाई जीरो माइनस एनी पॉइंट ऑन द सर्कल ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर. हियर वी हैव कंसिडर्ड एक्स जीरो माइनस एक्स वन एंड वाई जीरो माइनस वाई वन. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आर टू डिटेक्ट द सर्कल विद इन द इमेज एंड टू फाइंड द रेडियस एंड द सर्कल सेंटर ऑफ द डिटेक्टेड सर्कल्स. सो दिस इज द फ्लो चार्ट. हियर द फर्स्ट थिंग वी आर डूइंग इज गिविंग एन कलर्ड इमेज एज एन इनपुट. Then we are converting the colored image into a gray image for detection of the sharp edges. So after that we are using median filtering and selecting the threshold. So after selecting the threshold we get the binary image, and from the binary image we detect the circle center, and after detecting the circle center we get the radius of the circle. So here we are using MATLAB for the implementation of this circle detection. Initially we are taking a circle here we are using MATLAB for the implementation. Initially we are taking a colored image containing different circles or circular shapes. Then we are deciding certain region for the detection of the circles. After that we are converting the image into a grayscale so that we can easily differentiate between background and the circular images with the sharp changes that are edges. So here for the for finding centers and radii we are using the object polarity as dark, as we are converting the background in a lighter way. So here we are increasing the sensitivity to 0.92, which will help us in making the background lighter. So after that we are getting all the images having their centers and the radii. So this is the original image, which is colored image, and this is grayscaled image. Here we can easily see that the background is lighter and we can detect the different circles. This is the final output where we are getting all the centers here and radii of the circles here. So the application, that is the need of circle detection. In medical field where the size of the circle are very small and the detection of the circle and its parameters are not possible to be found by human naked eyes, this can be very useful. In medical industries, circular shapes tools can be detected. Application in mechanical industries. Circular shapes tools can be detected and its parameters can be checked accurately, as all the tools should be accurate and in proper size. This is useful in the mechanical industries too.
in space agencies. This can be very effective in calculating the size of the planets or stars, which are not possible without computer visions. Thank you.